What is going on, guys? It's your boy Brandon here again, back for another video. I just wanted to wish all you guys a happy new year, or if this video is posted before New Year's, still a happy new year, but be safe out there. Don't be doing anything stupid, no driving dumb, drinking and driving. That stuff just not called for. They have so many options out there, so that's your PSA for that. I just wanted to let you guys know that I'm going to start trying to do my videos a little bit different. They're going to be a little bit shorter, a little bit more choppier. If you haven't seen the last video, go ahead and do so. I feel like doing videos like that versus a long, drawn-out, chronological order kind of video is a better taste for me. I like it better. Everyone's time is valuable, so check out both videos, both ways I've been doing it. Let me know in the comment section which way you prefer, and that's the way I'll roll with. But personally, this is kind of the way I want to start doing videos. I like it a lot better, kind of just the highlights throughout the day. Obviously, when I do DIY stuff, it's going to have to be more drawn out. So yeah, anyways, today we're going to go ahead and tint the fog lights and the blinkers on the Jetta. Anyone who knows anything about Mark III's, it's like $300 to buy a decent set of French fog lights, and I don't feel like spending $300 on fog lights. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. I've done it in the past. If you guys haven't seen, I have a video on how to do it step by step with the 240. So go ahead and click on that link right up there and watch that. And if you have any curiosity on how to do it, that will show you. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I did have a couple people that have asked me before if there's anything I do other than car stuff. And I want you guys to know that is fun and stuff as cars are, there's a lot of other things that life has to offer out there, and I have a lot of other hobbies. So I went ahead and wanted to show you guys some of the other things that I do that I consider myself to be quite good at. So go ahead and check that out. Now you guys see why I do car shit. The first step in this process would be getting the Jetta in the garage. Also, if you guys might notice, I'm kind of walking around with these earphones on. I'm trying something different. My buddy Aaron over at Thrash Chassis, I'll go ahead and post their link over here. He'd given me an idea, and since I didn't really have the money and felt like buying a Rode mic, he said, why don't you try using some Bluetooth earphones? I had these laying around to see if it helps the audio quality, because I've had a lot of issues with the audio kind of going all over the place. So instead of sitting there and physically adjusting everything when editing a video, we're gonna give this a shot. And so go ahead and let me know if the audio seems a little bit better. That way I'm not stuck wearing these for 5 million years for no reason, but I figured I'd give it a shot. So thanks again, Aaron, and let's get on to working on this Jetta. Pull out the handy dandy stool. There she is. So essentially you could probably just do this with the lights on. Sometimes these screws get screwed up, but I don't really feel like doing it on. I feel like I could make it look a lot better if I take it off. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. But first, for all you guys who like to hate on bags, I want to show you a little something. As you can see, I'm not, you know, 100% really square with the car. I'm kind of going to reach over. So there's other benefits to bags besides saving oil pans. All right, guys. So now you can see they're all yellow. We actually moved the license plate over. We used the bracket that came with. What's up, Titan? Me and Tyson spent a good amount of time doing these, but they came out pretty good.
I'll give you guys a close up.
That blemish is actually cracking the fog light, or like cracking the glass, I guess you'd say. That was already there, so we didn't do that shit. But I'm happy. Now I just need to do some E-codes, let Tyson detail it, and get those wheels on there. That should be good. What do you think, Titan? You don't seem very amused. All right, so now we're on to task number two of the day. Pretty much the last task, hopefully. In the Audi, you're gonna go home. It needs pads and rotors, and it did have an issue with the sensor that was causing the brake light to come on, even though it wasn't necessarily the pads. The actual sensor was broken, so I'm gonna see if I can fix that, just at least get the warning light off the dash. And yeah, so we just got back to the house. The brakes are done on the Audi. Awesome. Jetta fogs look awesome. Rob's over. He fixed the drive line on the Rover. And now, for shits and giggles, we're going to have an air test. So we're going to see which car has the most travel, either the Rover or the Jetta. So go ahead and post in the comments below which one you think before we show you which one has the most travel. Obviously, the Jetta goes lower and the Rover goes higher. But we're going to see the whole travel. So which one you guys think has the most travel? We're going to measure that out right now. Sir up. Monster trucks are lifted. Let's see, where were you at before?
30, I don't remember.
Oh, 30 and a quarter. 30 and a quarter or 31 and a quarter?
30 and a quarter.
And now you're at 36 and a quarter?
Yeah, we'll call it a quarter. 36 and a quarter.
No, you're 36 and a half.
All right, 36 and a half.
36 and a half.
So that's...
Someone do the math. Cameron?
6 and a quarter.
6 and a quarter.
20. 24, yeah, not even close.
2 inches.
Dang. Well.
He lifted 2 inches height on you?
He got 2 inches taller, yeah.
Well, I saw the initial go up, and then I was like, up, and then it moved more. I was like, oh, he's got it.
Dang.
I could go more.
Want a race?
Oh, you dropped good.
If I went into the ECU, I
could
get more.
Oh, yeah, if I went in the bad comp, no, just kidding. It's alright, Jetta.
That, and if it detects that I'm high.
It's okay, speed. I still love you.
So as you guys can tell with my voice, I didn't really finish out the vlog yesterday. Time got away from me. I ended up going to the party and I still wanted to finish out the vlog. So I'm gonna do my best to do so with my voice being as gone as it is. I just wanted to wish you guys all a happy New Year's. I hope you guys had a nice, safe, eventful evening and none of you guys are feeling as crappy as I am right now. For all you guys that are new to the channel, I've been seeing all the Volkswagen videos. I did wanna let you know, if you do have any interest, this is my other car that you might not have seen yet. It's my 240SX with the KA24 DET. I have a whole series on me turboing the car and the stuff that I ran into, yada yada. So I encourage you guys to go check that out if you have any interest in this. This is my budget built 240. It's basically gonna be meant to drift and be a full, nice, specced out drift car for around $5,000 to $6,000, basically just to kind of show you guys that it is possible. I know drift tax seems insane, but if you're patient, you know the right people, and you keep looking out for deals, you can make it happen. So that car right there, for you guys who have been following that build and wanting to see more of the car, I've been telling you I wanted to get it tuned, so that's why it's kind of been sitting. Injectors, a math, and tune are on their way. It should be done ASAP, so we're gonna start hitting the track with that. Like I said before, I do have some pretty big surprises coming with this year. I guess it's not gonna be next year because it's January 1st. So if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button. Good stuff in store for that. Couple things I wanna square away with the Jetta. I've been telling you guys that I had some wheels that basically been sitting for a while that I'm gonna end up putting on the Jetta. So I thought, what better way to end the video than showing you guys the wheels that are gonna be on the Jetta before they go on the Jetta. So yeah. You guys ready? Bam.